Hello friends, welcome to Tech Study Cell. In this video, we'll make a complete home automation system using the ESP32 and a new Blynk IoT platform to control 8 relays with the Blynk IoT app, IR remote and from the manual switches. To make this project, you need a ESP32, 8-channel relay module, DHT11 sensor, 1838 IR receiver, LDR, so you don't need any custom designed PCB for this project, and I have not used any paid plan, so everything is free. And during the video I will share the complete circuit diagram, the code for this project, so anyone can make this project after watching the complete video. Now before going to the details, let me show you how this project works. First, let me control these appliances with the new Blynk IoT app through internet. After that, I will control these appliances with the IR remote, and you can monitor the real-time feedback in the Blynk IoT app. Now I will use these manual switches to control the appliances, and again you can monitor the real-time feedback in the Blynk app, and you can use this button to turn off all the lamps, and you can also monitor the temperature, humidity and the LDR reading in the Blynk IoT app. Now let me turn off some lights, and you can see the LDR value updated. Now let me turn on the lights again. Now I will increase the temperature with a dryer, and you can see the temperature value is changing. Now I will turn off the Wi-Fi to show you how this project works without internet. After turning off the Wi-Fi, you can see this blue LED start blinking, which indicates now the ESP32 is not connected with the internet. So I can control these appliances from the IR remote and also from the manual switches. Thus, you can control the appliances without internet. Now let me turn on the Wi-Fi again. After turning on the Wi-Fi, the ESP32 will automatically connect with the Wi-Fi, and you can see the blue LED is not blinking right now. So I can control these appliances with the Blynk IoT app. So this is a very useful home automation project, and please watch the complete video so that you don't face any issues during making this project. Now without any further delay, let's get started. To make this project, you need a ESP32, 8-channel relay module, DHT11 sensor, LDR, 1838 IR receiver to control the relays from IR remote, and to control the appliances manually you can use the existing switchboard. Now I will connect all these components as per this circuit diagram. The circuit is very simple. I have given the 5-volt supply to ESP32, relay module, DHT11 sensor and this IR receiver. These switches are connected across the GPIO pins and the ground pin. Now if you use push button, then you can refer to this circuit. Again, the push buttons are connected across the GPIO pins and the ground pin. And to connect the appliances with the relay module, you can refer to this circuit. And these control pins of the relay module are connected with the ESP32 as per this circuit. As you can see, there are a lot of connections, so to make the circuit compact, I have designed a PCB for this project, but as I said, you can also make this project without using any custom design PCB. Still, if you want to get this custom design PCB, then download the GABA file from the video description and order it from the JLC PCB. You can order any custom design PCB from JLC PCB with 3 simple steps. First, upload the GABA file, then select the parameter like quantity, PCB masking color. Then place the order. If you select faster delivery service, then you will get the PCB within a week. And as you can see, the quality of the PCB is very premium in this affordable price range. So you can always try JLC PCB for your any custom design PCB project. Now these are the components required for the PCB. Now I will quickly solder all the components on the PCB. After soldering, let me connect the ESP32 with the PCB. Then I will connect the DHT11 sensor, 1838 IR receiver, and at last I will connect the LDR with the PCB. We have connected all the sensors. Now I will connect the laptop with the ESP32 to upload the code. Now I have to configure the Blynk cloud account. So if you don't have any account, then click here to create an account. But as I have already an account, so I will enter the mail ID and password, then click on login. So first we have to create a template. For that I have to click here to go to templates, then click on new template. Here you have to give a name to the template. Then in the hardware you have to select the board. Here we are using ESP32, so I have selected ESP32. Connection type should be Wi-Fi. Now click on done. So after creating a template, you will get the template ID and device name, which will be required in the code. Now click on data stream, then click on new data stream and select the virtual pin. Now enter a name for this virtual pin. I will control relay 1 with this pin, so I am giving switch 1, and for switch 1 I will use V1 virtual pin. Data type will be integer and default value will be 0. Now click on create. So you can see first data stream is created. In a similar way, you have to create total 8 data stream with V1 to V8 virtual pin to control 8 relays. So here you can see we have created 8 data stream to control 8 relays with virtual pin V1 to V8. Now to turn off all the switch, we will add another data stream with V9. Let me give the name all off, then I will click on create. So I will use this data stream to turn off all the relay together. Now I will create the data stream for the temperature, humidity and LDR reading. So again I will click on new data stream and select the virtual pin. Let me give the name temperature, and in the pin I will select V10 to get the temperature reading. Data type should be double, and in the unit I will select degree Celsius. Then you can also set the minimum and maximum value. So here I am selecting minimum as 0 and maximum as 60 degree Celsius. After that click on create. Then let me create the data stream to get the humidity reading. Here I will select the V11 pin, and data type should be double. In the unit I will select percentage, and here minimum will be 0 and maximum will be 100. Now click on create. Now we will create the last data stream to get the reading from LDR. So again I will click on virtual pin. Here I will give the name LDR, then select the virtual pin as V12. Then I will set the minimum as 0 and maximum value as 10. Now click on create. So in this way you have to create total 12 data stream to control 8 relays and get the value from the sensors. After that we have to create the web dashboard. For that click on the web dashboard, then click and drag total 8 switch widget, as we will control 8 relays, and you also need the temperature and humidity reading, so click and drag 2 label widgets. Now you can resize the switch widget as per your requirement. Let me resize all the switch widget. Then if you hover over the switch widget, you will find this 3 button. So let me go to settings, which is the middle button. Here I will give the name as switch 1. Then I have to select the data stream. So here I will select V1. Then turn on this radio button to show the label. After that click on save. So in this way you have to configure all the switch widgets. After that I will hover over this label widget and go to settings. So here I will give the name as temperature, then select the data stream as V10, which you have configured for the temperature reading, and you can also turn on the color base value, so it will also show the color as per the value. Then click on save. Then I will configure the next level for the humidity reading. Let me resize the level. Now click on save to save all this configuration. After that, now we have to open the Blynk IoT app in the smartphone to configure the mobile dashboard. Now I will quickly configure the mobile dashboard in the Blynk IoT app. Let me open the app, then tap on login. Here you have to enter the email ID and the password for the Blynk cloud, then tap on login. Then I will go to developer mode, and we have already created this template, so I will tap on this template. So here we have to set up the mobile dashboard. I will tap on this three dash icon to open the widget box. Then from this widget box I will add total 9 buttons to control 8 relays and one button to turn off all the relays. Now let me resize the last button. Now again let me go to the widget box. Now we will add 3 gauge widgets to monitor the temperature, humidity and the LDR value. We have added all the widgets required for this project. Now I will tap on the first button. You can give any name to this button. Then you have to select the data stream. Here I am selecting V1 as I will control relay 1 with this button. Then mode will be switched. Now you can exit this button. Again I will tap on the next button and select the data stream as V2 and mode will be switched. In a similar way, you have to configure the first 8 button widgets to control the 8 relays. After that, I will tap on this button which I will use to turn off all the relays. So here I will select the virtual pin V9 and here the mode will be push. Then again I will exit from this button. Now I will tap on the first gauge widgets and here I will select the data stream V10 to show the temperature reading. Then I will tap on the next gauge widgets and select the data stream as V11 to show the humidity reading. Then I will tap on the last gauge widgets and select the V12 data stream to show the LDR value. Our mobile dashboard is ready. Now we can move to the coding part of this project. This is the code for this project. You can download this code from our website iotcircuithub.com. Just visit the article link given in the description, then you can download the code from these buttons. For this project, you have to download and install the ESP32 board and you need these 3 libraries. I have mentioned the version for the libraries which I have used for this project. In my previous video, I have already explained how to install the libraries and the ESP32 board in Arduino IDE. I will share the link in the video description. After installing the ESP32 boards and the libraries, you have to update the template ID and device name. For that, you have to go to the Blynk Cloud account, then go to the template and select the template which you have created. Then under the info tab, you will get the template ID and device name. Just click here to copy it and paste it here. After that, let me go to the void setup. So in the void setup, here you can see with this line, I am calling this sensor function after every 2 seconds to send the sensor data to Blynk server. So if you want, you can change this frequency. Now if I go to the send sensor function, here you can see in the send sensor function we are calling this read sensor to get the value from the LDR and the DHT11 sensor. So after getting this value, we are sending the value to the Blynk server. And to control the relays with the IR remote and the manual switches, I have used these 2 functions. Now if I go to the header file blynk.sn.h, you will find I have defined these 2 functions here. With this manual control function, we are controlling the relays from the manual switches. Then with the IR remote function, we are controlling the relays from the IR remote. You can use any IR remote. You just have to get the hex code of that IR remote button and accordingly update the hex code in this IR remote function, which is present in the blynk.sn.h header file. In my previous video, I have already explained how to get the hex code from any IR remote. So here you can see these are the hex code I will use for this project. To control the relay 1, I will use the button 1 of IR remote. You can configure any button to control the relays. Now I have to copy the hex code, then I have to paste it here. So you need 8 hex code to control 8 relays and accordingly update the hex code in this IR remote function. After doing this much of changes, you can directly go to tools, select the board as do it ESP32 dev kit V1 and proper COM port
Then click on the upload button to upload the code. Now I have to update the Wi-Fi name and password to ESP32. For that, I have to go to the main page of Blynk IoT app and tap on add new device. And during this time, this indicator LED should blink. Now it is blinking, so I will tap on ready. So this is the hotspot name. Now I will tap on the hotspot name. Now I will use this Wi-Fi network. So let me tap on it. This is the Wi-Fi name. Now let me enter the Wi-Fi password. After that, I will tap on continue. So this is the device name. You can also change it. Now again, I will tap on continue. Then tap on setup as new. Then tap on done. Then tap on the finish and exit. So this is the mobile dashboard, and we can monitor the temperature, humidity and LDR value. Let me turn on the relays, and you can see I can easily control the relays from this Blynk IoT app. Now I will connect the appliances with the relay module as per this circuit diagram.
Now let me control the appliances with the Blynk app, and you can see I can easily control it with the Blynk app. Now let me use the IR remote to control these lamps, and again I can easily control all the lamps from the IR remote. Now I will use the switch, and you can monitor the real-time feedback in the Blynk app, and I can also use this button to turn off all the lamps. And this is the temperature, humidity and the LDR value you can monitor in the Blynk IoT app. So this is a very useful project you can easily make. I have not used any paid plan, so anyone can make it after watching the video. And you can also join our Telegram channel Text Resell to get more such home automation ideas. If you like this video, then please hit the like button and share it with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe for more such videos. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.